Bombay High Court issues stay order on the demolition of Kangna's office in Mumbai, orders the Mumbai civic body to stop the demolition and file an affidavit before the court. The matter to be heard at 3 p.m. tomorrow. Kangna en route Mumbai amid high security reiterates that she is Maharashtra's daughter and Mumbai is her home and she is committed to fight for women's pride and self-respect. Riya shifted to the Mumbai jail, accused and arrested in the drugs link probe. The actor is sent to 14 days of judicial custody. And massive Prime Minister Kisan Yojana scam rocks Tamil Nadu. At least 5.5 lakh ineligible accounts exposed. Scam worth 120 crore rupees suspected to be spread across 13 districts. Political slugfest breaks out in the Karnataka drugs racket after the Congress alleged that the BJP has links with the arrested actors. Now the BJP tweets pictures of Congress leaders Siddaramaiah and DK Shivakumar with the two actors. And the AstraZeneca Oxford COVID-19 vaccine study halted. One of the recipients takes ill. The company investigates whether it is a side effect of the vaccine. Thanks for being with us. You're watching The Big Story here on Mirror Now. My name is Apoorva Sridhar. We have lots lined up for you in this edition of The Big Story. But first up, let's take a quick look at what's breaking this up. And news that's breaking this minute, the latest update coming in. The Bombay High Court has asked the BMC to stop the demolition of Kangna Ranaut's office in Mumbai. The BMC has asked to file an affidavit. The matter now will be heard at 3 p.m. tomorrow. So that's the big news now coming in at this point. The Bombay High Court, they're asking the Mumbai civic body to stop the demolition drive of Kangna Ranaut's office in Mumbai. Remember earlier, the BMC had undertaken the demolition of the alleged illegal portion of Kangna's office in Mumbai. Now the matter to be heard at 3 p.m. tomorrow. Let me go across to my colleague Disha, who's joining us for further updates on this. Disha, this is a big development now coming in with regards to Kangna Ranaut's office, which was earlier demolished by the BMC. Now an order coming in from the Bombay High Court. Take us through the details of this order and what has the court said?
It has said that there will be no demolition by the BMC, at least till further orders. Bombay High Court has asked BMC to stop the demolition of Kangna Ranaut's bungalow, which is in Khar West of Mumbai, her office premises, where at least for 2 hours today, the demolition drive did really take place. In fact, BMC has been asked to file an affidavit by the Bombay High Court, and now the matter will be heard tomorrow at 3 p.m. So it all started today when the BMC, after the 24-hour deadline ended, they put up another notice at Kangna Ranaut's office premises, where they said that considering she has not really submitted the documents as asked by the BMC yesterday, the demolition will continue. And within the span of 10 minutes, there were at least 25 to 30 workers at the spot, and they started the demolition drive. Of course, to that, Kangana's team of lawyers, they went to the Bombay High Court. They clearly said that it is contempt to the court, because Bombay High Court has ordered that there will be no demolition that will take place by the BMC in the city of Mumbai till 30th of September, keeping in mind the COVID situation. And what BMC is doing is contempt of the court. So the matter was heard at about 12:30 today in the afternoon. It went on for at least an hour. And later, the Bombay High Court has announced this, that to stop the demolition drive till further orders.
All right, Disha, many thanks for joining us and giving us all those updates there in this case. Meanwhile, this is an all-out war between Kangna Ranaut and the Maharashtra government that has now escalated further. Now, all eyes are going to be on Kangna Ranaut as the actor will shortly land in Mumbai after parts of her office, remember, has been raised down by the BMC today. During the first course of the day, Kangna Ranaut has posted a series of tweets there, creating a storm on internet, taking on the BMC and the Mahagadi government. In her last tweet that she has put out, Kangna has reiterated her Mumbai is POK drive and challenged the Bollywood to speak up against what she has called was fascism. Now, Kangana also went on to compare the Maharashtra government and the BMC officials to Babar and its goons while comparing her office building to the Ram Mandir. Let me go across to my colleague Neha Kulkarni, who's joining us live at this point. She's joining us live from the Mumbai airport. Neha, give us a sense of what you're looking around you. We are, of course, looking at Kangana Ranaut, who would be expected at the Mumbai airport shortly. Take us through the details. What do you see around you? There is, of course, a lot of confrontation that is expected. All right, we'll try and reconnect with Neha in just a bit, but she's joining us from outside the Mumbai airport, where just a short while back, we'd also seen a protest that was also taking place. We'd also seen members of the Republican Party who was also there in support of Kangana Ranaut. So we are looking at a lot of drama that is also expected at the Mumbai airport, where the actor would be arriving shortly at the Mumbai airport. And remember, this coming at a time where parts of her office has already been raised by the BMC today. And just before taking off, she had in fact put out a series of tweets there that had also created quite a storm on the internet. And in those tweets, she had directly taken on the BMC and the Mahagadi government. Let me go across to my colleague Neha Kulkarni, who's joining us from the Mumbai airport for those updates. Neha, what do you see around you? What is the kind of security arrangements being put up for Kangana Ranaut? Because we are looking at a lot of confrontation, perhaps. There's already been parts of her office building that has been razed down by the BMC. What do you see around you at the Mumbai airport?
Apoorva, at the Mumbai airport, we can see a kind of atmosphere has built up to be able to receive the actor and show their support and solidarity for the actor by political workers here, and also considering that the cops have come in for her protection here at the airport. This has been the scene for the past 1 hour. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Right at the gate, there are CISF officials guarding from the point that she will be coming out of the airport till about outside. Now, this is the G3 gate that we are showing you. Basically, it's the gate used by the very important people at the Mumbai airport when they are coming out of the airport, and this is something that the airport officials are informed about, and which is why we are expecting that Kangana Ranaut will be coming out from this airport. And these are the visuals which my video journalist Manoj Halwa is showing you of how packed the security is right at the gate itself. Now what I'm going to show you is the lane here from which she will come out. As you can see, a complete barricaded lane has been put for the actor, and here also female CISF cops and officials are out here with the airport security staff. Now, all those in the orange jackets and the green jackets that are being seen right now are the airport security guard posted at close to about 2 to 3 meters away so that they can give the required protection to the actor. Here, on the other side, what I'm showing you is the Mumbai police corps. The Mumbai police corps have come here. There are female Mumbai police constables and the other Mumbai police constables. Mumbai police inspector had earlier come in to take a view of the situation about how the security is well maintained over here, and there are a couple of 30 to 30 cops here out at the airport itself. What I'm showing you this side are the workers from the Republican Party of India. Remember earlier RPI chief Ramdas Athawale made a statement and how he's going to give support to Kangana Ranaut, show his protection towards her by ensuring that supporting what the actor has had to say about the government, and saying that any effort by the government in stopping her from exercising her freedom of speech is absolutely not correct. And which is why we can see the RPI workers here. So this is the kind of 360-degree arrangement here outside the airport itself. The atmosphere, as I was showing you, has already been built up to receive the actor here. And it is also important, Apoorva, as to what the actor will say. Because remember, it's only a couple of minutes now that we can see her coming out of the gate. What the actor has to say about the entire way in which the government has acted against her, be it the action that has been taken against the illegal construction, as the BMC is calling it, of her office premise, now that the Bombay High Court has also brought in a stay on the demolition. What does Kangana have to say about the way Mahavikas Agadi government has been making comments about Kangana's claim on Mumbai? Because remember, she's called this city a Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. She's compared the coalition government to Taliban. So all of this is important to hear from the actor's mouth as to what she has to say about the way she has been receiving the kind of threats, if you can say in a way, from Mumbai.
So, Neha, what we're looking at is an elaborate arrangement there at the Mumbai airport. We're looking at the cops there at the Mumbai airport. And let's not forget, the center has also given Kangana Ranaut a vice security as well. So, we are, of course, looking at a lot of security there at the airport. But also, Neha, with regards to the support and the solidarity that is pouring in, what do you see around you? We do see some of the people from the Republican Party of India had suggested yesterday. But what about the other support that is pouring in? Are we looking at any kind of protest that is also taking place at the Mumbai airport?
In terms of sloganeering, Apurva, the only kind of sloganeering that we are seeing in support of the actor is by the Republican Party of India. I'll just quickly show you what are the claims that they are making. They are saying, Kangana ke samman mein, we are here. We are here to support the actor. We are here to tell them and show that we are with her. Let me quickly tell you why they are here. Sir, aap aaj yahan pe kyun hai? Kangana ji ki security RPI ke liye itni zaruri kyun?
देखिए, एक कंगना जी को सिक्योरिटी दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट ने दे दिया है, लेकिन महाराष्ट्र गवर्नमेंट का जो एक खासदार है संजय राउत, उन्होंने उनको तोड़फोड़ करने का वादा किया है और उसको यहाँ रहने का दावा किया है कि वहाँ नहीं रहने देंगे, तो वो उसने गलत काम किया है। और दूसरी बात यह है कि महिला के बारे में एक जिम्मेदार संपादक, सामना का संपादक अगर ऐसा बोलता है तो उनका जो बोलना एकदम गलत है, महिला का विनय भंग करने जैसा है। दूसरी बात यह है कि भारतवर्ष में संविधान चल रहा है, संविधान के टाइम में कोई भी कुछ भी बोल सकता है, कुछ भी कर सकता है, लेकिन किसको कानून हाथ में नहीं ले सकता है। उसने कानून हाथ में लिया है, उनका जो दफ्तर है वो तोड़ दिया है, उसको म्युनिसिपैलिटी में उसकी सत्ता है उसको।
तो आप लोगों का क्या एम है? आप क्यों उन्हें प्रोटेक्शन देना चाहते? कहाँ तक प्रोटेक्शन देंगे?
वो एक महिला है, वो हमारे बॉम्बे की भारत इज्जत है, नाक है वो औरत। मैं भी एक औरत हूँ। अब वैसे ही कुछ गलत वर्ड यूज करेगा तो हम लोगों को गुस्सा आएगा, उस गुस्से में मैं आई हूँ, सेफ्टी हो कुछ, क्योंकि उनका भरोसा नहीं, जिस तरह से वो आक्रोश में है शिवसेना वाले। मैम, जहाँ तक जाना घर तक जाएंगे हम लोग, क्योंकि वो हमारे बॉम्बे की नाक है, वो कुछ हंसती है, वो ऐसा कुछ उल्टा नहीं, उन्हें सच के साथ खड़ी हुई है वो। जो आज तक पूरे बॉलीवुड में जिप लग गया है सबको, एक बंदी अकेली खड़ी होकर सच का सामना कर रही है, तो हम उनको सैल्यूट करते हैं, इसलिए उनके साथ हैं।
वंस अगेन पूर्वा, दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द आरपीआई वर्कर्स हु कम इन हियर, एंड एट द सेम टाइम अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस इट इज ओनली द डिफेंस गाइज विच इज द मुंबई कॉप्स, द सीआईएसएफ, द एयरपोर्ट एंड द अदरवाइज द प्राइवेट सिक्योरिटी फ्रॉम एयरपोर्ट हु आर हियर टू गिव द एक्टर द सपोर्ट एंड ऑल्सो द सिक्योरिटी राइट व्हेन शी कम्स आउट ऑफ द एयरपोर्ट।
All right, Neha, keep tracking those developments for us very closely. We'll of course come back to you for the latest. We are expecting Kangana Ranaut to arrive at the Mumbai airport shortly. We'll come back to you for all the latest updates coming in. Let's also tell our viewers about the other latest developments that has come in with regards to the demolition drive that was carried on by the BMT. Now, the Bombay High Court has put a stay order on Mumbai's civic body demolition of the parts of Kangana's office in Mumbai. The High Court has asked the BMC to file an affidavit and also, in fact, go ahead and oppose the affidavit. And also, the matter would be heard again tomorrow at 3 p.m. Now, remember, this after the Mumbai civic body raised the alleged illegal portion of the actor's office. The demolition took place after the BMC rejected Kangana's 7-day request to respond to its notice. The BMC cited that the reply filed by the actor was unsatisfactory and proceeded to demolish even as Kangana's staff there protested outside the office. Meanwhile, when Mirror now confronted Maharashtra Home Minister Anil Deshmukh on this issue, he evaded the question on this entire controversy surrounding Kangana Ranaut.
So Kangana Ranaut will be coming to Mumbai today, and you have said that she should not come if she has insulted Maharashtrians and people of Maharashtra.
Sir, a demolition action is going on in Kangana Ranaut's Pali Hill property. It is being termed as vendetta politics. How do you look at it?
Please. Will you react on that, sir?
Sir, anything on the threat that you have received?
So even you have received threat from Himachal saying that
you stay away from this property. Sir, there are reports that you have received threats.
With that, we are slipping into a very short break. Back in just a bit. We're getting some more updates coming in. Actor Diya Mirza has now tweeted on the demolition drive at Kangana's office. Diya Mirza, in fact, tweeted, she said, and I quote, "Kangana comparing Mumbai to POK is not acceptable, but there is absolutely no doubt that BMC moving to suddenly conduct a demolition of areas of her office space is totally questionable. Why now? Why like this? What were you doing all this while if there were irregularities? So that's the tweet. They're coming in from Diya Mirza, who has also raised questions on the demolition drive by the BMC, while going on to say that Kangana comparing Mumbai to POK is not acceptable, but there is absolutely no doubt that BMC moving to suddenly conduct a demolition of areas of our office space is totally questionable. So that's the remark now coming in from Diya Mirza, who has spoken out regarding the demolition drive that was carried out at the office of Kangana Ranaut. Just a short while back, we'd seen how almost 2 hours we'd seen the BMC workers there gathered to demolish the illegal portion of Kangana's office, following which we'd also seen Kangana's team taking a legal route, after which we saw how the Bombay High Court stayed BMC's demolition drive at Kangana's Mumbai office, asking the BMC to file an affidavit and the matter to be heard tomorrow at 3 p.m. However, now we're looking at more support now pouring in at this point with regards to many celebs questioning the demolition drive that has been carried out at the office of Kangana Ranaut. We're getting some more updates coming in another news. This coming in from down south. A massive Prime Minister Kisan Yojana scam has rocked Tamil Nadu, with at least 5.5 lakh ineligible farmer accounts that has now been exposed. Thousands of ineligible accounts gaining benefits of the scheme. Several officers from the Agriculture Department, self-help groups, data entry operators are currently being questioned by the CBCID team. The investigating agency, CBCID, cracked down on 80 staff members, which include the computer staff and the block managers as well. Upon the request of the district collector, it was found that the chairman of the banks were instructed to reverse the money from such ineligible beneficiaries. The scam was allegedly carried out in 13 districts of Tamil Nadu. Let me go across to my colleague Pramod, who's joining me live, getting us further updates on this. Pramod, this is a big scam which is related. This is a big central scam, in fact, that is related to the Prime Minister Kisan Yojana that has been unearthed. Tell us about how this came to light and what were the modus operandi that was followed by the scamsters.
Well, it absolutely is a huge scam where we are currently expected between 110 crores to 120 crores has been provided to ineligible beneficiaries. The thing is that as per PM Kisan Yojana, Samman Yojana, a farmer who is eligible is supposed to get 6,000 rupees in 3 terms of 2,000 rupees every year. And what they have done is that the eligibility criteria is that you can be any kind of farmer, but you have to hold a piece of land, and also only one person from a family can actually be a beneficiary. But what has occurred is that, as per the officials, they claim that the password that is required to authenticate it was provided to the block level officers, like block development officer, block manager, and this password was either stolen, leaked, or in connivance was sold to certain, the computer center, data center people in rural areas who have used it. Now, Tamil Nadu CBCID, the police CBCID, is investigating the case, and they have found out this scam to be spread across 13 districts. More than 80 personnel involved in this has been suspended so far, and the officials from the government claim that they are trying to retrieve the money, and so far 35 crore rupees have been retrieved.
All right, Prabodh, stay with us at this point. We are in fact getting some news that's breaking this minute coming in from the top court. This is the latest update coming in regarding the Maratha quota case in the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court, they're saying that no quota for jobs and admissions for 2020-21, and has also Supreme Court sending the validity matter to a larger bench. That's the latest update now coming in at this point with regards to the Maratha quota case in the Supreme Court, where the Supreme Court has now sent the validity matter to a larger bench. Also saying that the admissions to the PG not to be altered, and the Chief Justice of India to decide the larger bench composition as well. Let me go across to our Deputy News Editor Meenakshi Bhanja for further updates on this. Meenakshi, take us through the details that are coming in a big development. We're also looking at the Supreme Court sending the validity matter to a larger bench as well.
Well, Apoorva, at the outset, we have to clarify for our viewers that this is the operative part that we are getting for our viewers. The details and the finer text, the
finer points of the judgment will be known shortly once it is made available and uploaded. But the breaking news that we are getting for our viewers at this point in time is the Supreme Court's interim orders on the Maratha quota is in, where the Supreme Court has gone ahead and said that no Maratha quota will be applicable for jobs and admissions for the year 2020 to 2021. And the Supreme Court has also additionally sent the validity question of the Maratha reservation to a larger bench composition. And the Supreme Court, like you rightly mentioned, has added that the admissions to the PG courses that has happened thus far will not be altered. The Chief Justice of India will go on to decide the larger bench composition that will go on to eventually adjudicate on the validity question of Maratha quota. Very quickly, our viewers will recall that all the counsels that have appeared in this matter, senior eminent counsels, likes of Mr. Kapil Sibal to Mr. Mukul Rohtagi, they have all urged upon the Supreme Court to have this issue of Maratha quota be evaluated by a larger bench composition of the top court.
All right, Meenakshi, many thanks for joining us and bringing us all those breaking updates there from the top court. We're getting more breaking updates coming in with regards to Riya Chakrabarty's bail plea, which is going to be now heard tomorrow. That's the latest update coming. Remember, she has now been sent to the judicial custody till September 22nd, and her bail plea is now going to be heard tomorrow. With that, we're slipping into a very short break. Back with the big story on the other side. We're getting some breaking news updates coming in at this point. We're looking at high drama there at the Mumbai airport as well at this point, because of the all-out war that has broken out between Kangana Ranaut and the Maharashtra government. All eyes will be on the actor, who will be landing in Mumbai shortly after parts of her office, remember, were raised by the BMC today. In fact, during that course of the day, Kangana Ranaut had posted series of tweets, creating a storm on the internet as well. And in her tweet, Kangana had once again reiterated her Mumbai is POK jibe and has also challenged Bollywood to speak up against what she called was fascism. Kangana also went on to compare the Maharashtra government and BMC officials to Babar and its goons while comparing her office building to the Ram Mandir. In fact, at the Mumbai airport, we're also looking at a large crowd that has also now gathered in support of Kangana Ranaut and giving out their solidarity to the actor. Just a short while back, my colleague Neha Kulkarni, who's at the airport, gave us updates of how people from the Republican Party of India have also now gathered in a show of support for Kangana Ranaut. Meanwhile, we'd also seen a massive security arrangement and elaborate security arrangements there being made at the Mumbai airport as well, where the actor is expected to arrive shortly. And remember, all of this happening at a time where the actor's Mumbai office was raised by the BMC today morning in a two-hour demolition drive that had taken place, following which the actor had taken out a legal recourse, and then the Bombay High Court eventually stayed the demolition by the BMC. Let's listen to some of the reactions they're coming in at this point.
और आगे भी अगर कंगना जी को जरूरत पड़ेगी अभी तो हम उनके घर पर छोड़कर आएंगे. आगे भी अगर कंगना जी को हमारी जरूरत होगी तो हम क्राइस्टचर्च करने से ना उनके घर पर रुकने को तैयार है.
There are a lot of reactions there pouring in support of Kangana Ranaut, who's en route Mumbai. Let me go across to my colleague Disha, who's joining me with further updates on this. Disha, at the Mumbai airport, we're definitely looking at a lot of people, a lot of support there pouring in for Kangana Ranaut. Help us understand right now, what is the status of Kangana Ranaut's arrival in Mumbai? What are you picking up on those front? All right, we'll try and reconnect with Disha in just a bit, but those are the details and important updates there coming in at this point with regards to the actor Kangana Ranaut, as she is expected to land shortly in Mumbai. And this, remember, coming at a time where parts of her office were also raised by the BMC today in that two-hour demolition drive that had been carried out. Let me bring in my colleague Disha for further updates on this. Disha, shortly, we're expecting Kangana Ranaut to arrive at the Mumbai airport. It is going to be hugely significant, coming at a time where parts of her office have been razed down. There is, of course, a stay order that has been put out by the Bombay High Court as well. So, what are the details you're picking up at this point in this whole issue?
Well, that's right. The Bombay High Court just a short while ago has passed an order saying that the PMC has to stop the demolition drive which is going on at Kangana Ranaut's office premises. And in fact, no demolition drive will continue till at least further order. So definitely there has been a stay that has been put up by the Bombay High Court as far as BMC's demolition drive is concerned. And now anytime soon, yes, we are expecting Kangana Ranaut to actually land at land in Mumbai. We are not too sure whether her flight has landed or not. It was supposed to land at about 2:20. But definitely, okay. As and when she comes out, she is going to be, because as we all know, that for at least 2 hours today, in her absence, the BMC went ahead and continued the demolition. A lot of structures which were illegal were demolished by the BMC. We are yet to get a clarity as to whether the BMC could complete the entire demolition today or not, but that's something which we are waiting confirmation from the BMC about.
All right. Also, Disha, it is hugely significant because at the Mumbai airport, while we're looking at heightened security there, we're also looking at massive support and solidarity they're pouring in with several groups right now at the Mumbai airport, sloganeering and in support of Kangana Ranaut as well.
Well, that's right, because we have also seen on Twitter and we have seen today when several of the organizations and groups actually reached the airport, they did really say that BMC did was not at all fair, and what BMC, at least they should have waited for her to come back and then they would have started with the demolition drive or anything of that sort. So definitely there's a lot of support which Kangana is receiving as and when we speak. But now, of course, as soon as she comes, she will have to go under a 7-day quarantine period, Apurva, as per the Mumbai Civic Body rules and norms due to the COVID situation. So it will be really now interesting to see, because now the court will be hearing the matter tomorrow again at about 3 o'clock. So we'll have to wait for that hearing as well.
Also, Disha, if you can quickly recap to us what happened at the Bombay High Court today. While going ahead and staying the demolition drive, what were the other important orders that had come in from the Bombay High Court?
Well, clearly when the BMC put a second notice today at about 10:30 a.m. after the 24-hour deadline ended, the BMC said that considering Kangana could not submit all the relevant proofs or sanctions or approvals of permission, then the demolition drive would continue. To that, of course, the team of Kangana lawyer responded to it, saying that it will be a contempt to the court because the Bombay High Court has passed an order that due to the COVID situation, no demolition activity can take place here in the city of Mumbai till at least 30th of September. So they immediately filed a writ petition at the Bombay High Court, which was heard at about 12:30 p.m. today. And it went on for at least an hour, where now the court has said, and they have asked BMC to stop the demolition that moment, and now the matter will be heard tomorrow at about 3 o'clock.
All right, Disha, while we are looking at those developments, and since morning you've been reporting for us outside the office of Kangana Ranaut, where parts of it allegedly, according to the BMC, were illegal, has there any response really come in from the BMC right after the court, in fact, had ordered for the demolition to be stayed and for them to file an affidavit? Has any kind of reaction there come in from the BMC on this entire demolition drive, which has also been now questioned by several celebrities? We'll try and reconnect with Disha in just a bit, but important updates there coming in. We're expecting Kangana Ranaut, who will be landing in Mumbai shortly. And remember, this coming in after her office, parts of her office was raised by the BMC today. In fact, through the course of the day, we've also seen some series of tweets there coming in where Kangana Ranaut took on the BMC as well as the Mahagadi government. In her latest tweet, in fact, Kangana once again reiterated her Mumbai is POK Jai and also now challenged several of the Bollywood to celebrities to even speak up against what she in fact termed as fascism. Now, she also went on to compare the Maharashtra government and the BMC officials to Babar and its goons while comparing her office building to the Ram Mandir. So on the left of your screens, you're looking at the BMC, which had cited illegal alterations and constructions. They had put out a notice in front of her office in Mumbai and had given them a 24-hour ultimatum, after which the BMC went on to reject Kangana's 7-day request to respond to the BMC notice. And today morning at around 11 a.m., parts of her office portions was in fact demolished. Right after that, we saw a team Kangana in fact take a legal recourse, and they had approached the Bombay High Court, in fact filing a writ against the demolition, seeking a stay on the demolition. And right after the hearing that had taken place, the Bombay High Court in fact stayed the BMC's demolition drive at Kangana's Mumbai office, asking the BMC to file an affidavit, and this matter is now going to be heard at 3 p.m. Now, we're also looking at further updates coming in, and we're expecting Kangana Ranaut to in fact land in Mumbai shortly, because remember, at the Mumbai airport, there's also a huge crowd that we're looking at, whether it is the supporters of the Republican Party of India. There are also supporters of the Karni Sena who have now gathered at the Mumbai airport, showing their support and solidarity for the actor Kangana Ranaut. While on the other hand, we're also looking at a massive security that is also seen at the Mumbai airport. The Mumbai police, who have barricaded quite a lot of the portions of the Mumbai airport, while there have been several sloganeering and support and chants they're pouring in support of Kangana Ranaut. We'll try and get all of those updates that are coming in. But remember, there is a massive show of strength by the RPI and the Karni Sena workers with regards to the demolition drive that has been carried out against Kangana Ranaut. And we are expecting Kangana Ranaut to arrive at the Mumbai airport shortly. We're getting those live images there from the Mumbai airport at this point. We believe that Kangana Ranaut has arrived at the Mumbai airport. We're trying to get more updates on that front. But those are images there coming in from the Mumbai airport at this point. And we'll try and get more updates of what is happening, because remember, outside the Mumbai airport, we're looking at a sea of supporters there. Whether it is the Karni Sena or it is the Republican Party of India, we are looking at a massive show of strength and support there pouring in for Kangana Ranaut. Remember, this coming in at a time where portions of her office was also raised by the BMC, citing alterations and illegal construction there by the actor. So right now, we're looking at all the updates now coming in. We'll try and get more updates with regards to what is happening.
As you know, she has been provided with the Y-plus security, and which is why the security provided by the MHA has made sure that she lands first and she has got out of the aircraft. She will be going towards the lounge from where she will be going towards her residence in Mumbai. We have been trying to give messages to her to kindly speak to the media at the terminal. So it has not been, there has been no revert from Kangana Ranaut as of now, but there are words that she might be speaking to the people and the media who have been travelling with her inside the aircraft at the terminal in Mumbai, at the Mumbai airport. So we will have to wait and watch. What most importantly we wanted to ask Kangana Ranaut is the fact that how does she feel? Isn't she threatened to come back to Mumbai? Because she had received a lot of threat calls asking her not to come back to Mumbai, and now that her office at Paddy Hills Road has also been demolished by the BMC officials, it is getting extremely difficult to get a hand on Kangana Ranaut and to ask her these questions. But meanwhile, when we were in the flight with her, we times now tried to ask her questions. All she said is that she wants some time to take it all in. She is just going to Mumbai. She had promised her, her family, her fans, everyone, that she will be coming back to Mumbai on 9th of September, and that is what she's done. We have been traveling with her since Chandigarh airport. Pranesh, I would like to tell you that we saw Kangana Goli and Kangana were constantly on the phone. They were checking our tweets. They were tweeting from the Team Kangana handle, and that is what we saw, that they were constantly busy on their phones trying to get updates on what's happening in the state of Maharashtra. For example, you have seen how there have been comments coming from Sanjay Raut, the Shiv Sena leader, also from Anil Deshmukh, who is the Home Minister of Maharashtra. So all these questions that we wanted to ask Kangana that how she would like to respond to all of this. To that, she didn't really have a response in the flight. She said she might speak to the media at the terminal. So we will be getting off from the bus, which is taking us to the terminal right now, and trying to speak to Kangana Ranaut at the terminal, trying to get some clarity, because from her body language, she seemed extremely confident. She didn't seem threatened at all by all the threat calls that she's been getting. In fact, when she was in Mandi district also at her father's residence, she was even then very strongly feeling to come back to Mumbai, and which is why she had tweeted about the fact that even though you want to pull me down and I am not that kind of a person who will become a pawn for someone else, so I am not that act, I'm not that girl, and which is why she has come back to Mumbai to face what's happening here. As we all know, her office in Pali Hill Road has also been demolished by the BNC. We also wanted to ask her.
All right, we were listening into one of our ground reports there coming in from my colleague Kangana, who's there at the Mumbai airport. We can now confirm to our viewers that Kangana Ranaut has in fact arrived in Mumbai. And of course, outside of the Mumbai airport, we are looking at a sea of people, supporters there, both from Karni Sena as well as the RPI members at the airport, standing in solidarity with Kangana Ranaut. In fact, let's quickly listen into a reaction there coming in from Rizwan Siddiqui, Kangana Ranaut's lawyer, on this entire case. All right, we'll try and get that reaction in just a bit. But remember, this is, of course, a massive development now coming in. Kangana Ranaut has just arrived in Mumbai. And right now, outside the Mumbai airport, we're looking at a sea of supporters there, both from the Karni Sena, the RPI members, the Republican Party of India members, who are there at the Mumbai airport at this point. Let me bring in my colleague Disha for those updates there. Disha, this is going to be hugely significant to see how the situation pans out, because right now Kangana Ranaut has arrived in India, but outside the Mumbai airport, we're looking at a sea of supporters. We're looking at massive support, solidarity there pouring in for Kangana Ranaut, whether it is the Karni Sena or the RPI members, all waiting outside, chanting in support of Kangana Ranaut.
Well, that's right. Indeed, Kangana Ranaut has landed here in the city of Mumbai. From Chandigarh, she took a flight at about 12:30. And right now, we are looking at her landing in Mumbai. We are, in fact, getting visuals. We also got some visuals from the international airport about high police presence, security, and even a lot of supporters chanting slogans for her in, you know, showing her support and love. And of course, this is going to be here because we are looking at that in her absence, the BMC went ahead and demolished her office premises, specifically the illegal portion, for at least 2 hours. In fact, she was the one who also had demanded for a 7-day request from the BMC notice, but that was rejected, and the BMC went ahead and continued the demolition drive. So today when she comes, she'll definitely straight away go to her house, because she has to be quarantined for 7 days. She has to be quarantined for 7 days as per the norms due to the COVID situation. So it will be very significant and important to look at now what the team, Kangana, responds to all of this. Because before landing the flight, she had tweeted a couple of pictures, demolition pictures. She had also, tweeted a lot of things about that it's the death of democracy and there is nothing illegal which is there inside her office premises. But BMC, whatever they are doing is not right. It is contempt to court. And that's what exactly happened. Kangana had filed a writ petition against the BMC at the Bombay High Court. And the hearing, of course, took place. And the court has asked BMC to stop the demolition drive and not continue till the further orders. So all of this we are looking at. And very shortly, she has landed. So we are looking at her coming out of the airport very soon. So there have been arrangements made, done at the international airport. And we all know that she's been given white plus security as well. So that is something which is, of course, very significant to look at here specifically. And even more important now, Apoorva, will be to see whether she straight, she goes and just, she can take a glimpse at her office, which is very close to her residence, or she will be directly going to her residence. So this is something which will now be very important to look at.
Absolutely. Those are the extremely important updates that are coming in at this point. But also, Disha, hugely significant to note what is going to be the next course of action for Team Kangana, because she's going to be returning to part of her office that has also been demolished. Afterwards, we'd also seen the Bombay High Court stay the demolition. So it is going to be hugely significant. Disha, what have you picked up on that front from the lawyers of Kangana Ranaut? What is going to be the next course of action?
Well, the lawyers today in the court, they very specifically and clearly said that even before the BMC rejected her reply to the notice, the BMC was ready to demolish, the illegal portions of the premises and concerns. So Kangana's lawyer has been maintaining that it is only, politics that the BMC is really playing here after her remarks and after her war of words between the state government and concern, and that is the reason she's been targeted. So those are the claims that the lawyers had really put at front. In fact, the lawyer today also said that it is completely contempt to the court, considering the court has said that no demolition will take place at least till 30th of September, but BMC went ahead and did it. They, in fact, did not even pay any heed to Kangana's request of having at least 7 days' time to submit all the documents. So all of these are allegations that are being, or claims by the Kangana's lawyer in concern. So tomorrow, again, the matter is going to be heard at 3 p.m., which will be, again, important. And now, of course, we're looking at that the flight has landed. She will be out very shortly after, completing all the formalities. So we are looking at another 10 to 15 minutes and she will be out from the airport. And then whether she goes straight away to her house in Bandra or she goes to the office premises where the demolition drive really took place, that is something which will be important to look at.
Absolutely. Disha, request you to stay with us at this point. We are just going to come back to you in a bit. Let me just quickly recap for our viewers what is happening right now. Kangana Ranaut has in fact arrived at the Mumbai airport. And there is, of course, a sea of supporters there outside. We're looking at members of the Karni Sena. We're looking at members of the Republican Party of India. They're all there at the Mumbai airport. There is a massive crowd at the Mumbai airport. Let's not forget it is the Corona times as well. And we're looking at protests that are also now taking place at the Mumbai airport as well. While there is a lot of security that has been present at this point, but we are looking at a massive showdown there at the Mumbai airport. We'll try and get more updates of what's happening at the Mumbai airport while there is tight security at this point. But these are updates now coming in from the Mumbai airport. She has, of course, landed. And we are looking at a lot of security outside the Mumbai airport as well. Remember, this coming just after parts of her office were in fact raised by the BMC, following which Team Kangana had opted for a legal recourse and they got the Bombay High Court, who stayed the BMC's demolition drive at Kangana's Mumbai office. Now we're looking at further updates coming in of certain protests that are also now taking place at the Mumbai airport. Let me once again go back to my colleague Disha for further updates on this. Disha, there is certainly going to be a massive showdown that is expected at the Mumbai airport, because now we're also getting news about some kind of protests that are also now taking place at the Mumbai airport, Disha.
Looking at, on one side, a lot of supporters, but on the other side as well, we are looking at, workers, Karni Sena, of course, and more RPI workers and Karni Sena workers have joined. And they are also, saying slogans about, against her, about, whatever she is said about Mumbai and whatever comments she's really making against the state government. That is something, it's not tolerable. It's unacceptable. In fact, it's the Bhartiya Kamgar Sena that has come to protest against Kangana. A lot many people had come. In fact, police had to actually man the entire situation as well, keeping in mind the social distancing norms. And yes, definitely we are looking at Kangana arriving shortly. Outside, the flight has landed, what we are being told, and very soon, 10 to 15 minutes after completing all the formalities, she'll walk out of the international airport, and whether she'll visit her office premises or house is something that we'll have to closely look at.
All right, we'll get more updates now coming in. Disha, many thanks for joining us and bringing us all those updates there. This continues to be our top focus story. High drama there at the Mumbai airport where Kangana Ranaut has just arrived at the Mumbai airport. While we are looking at a sea of supporters there, both from the Karni Sena, the Republican Party of India, we're also looking at some protests that are also taking place at the Mumbai airport. We are slipping into a very short break. We'll be back with more news and updates on the other side.